My name is Father José Martins Fernandes. I am Portuguese by birth, a consulate missionary, and I am celebrating this year 42 years of priesthood. I arrived here in Canada, in Toronto, in 2013, and I was coming straight from South Africa. I've been here now 6 years working at the parish of St. Andrews, which is situated in North Etobicoke, Toronto. Part of the Archdiocese of Toronto, a big archdiocese with 225 parishes, 1.9 million Catholics. In those parishes we celebrate masses in 33 languages, including signing language. Here at St. Andrew we use 4 languages: English, Italian, Spanish, and Twi, which is from Ghana, since St. Andrews hosts the Ghanaian community of Toronto. This parish of St. Andrews has been served during the recent past, since 2003, has been served by the Consolata missionaries. The first pastor was Father Carlos Sierra Tobon. Then in 2008 came Father Horacio Zuluaga Zuluaga, both of them from Colombia, and in 2013 it was my turn, the superiors sent me here. Our parish is celebrating 50 years of existence as a building, but it is older some 2 years as a parish, because it started without a building. It is situated in an area of population that is middle class, perhaps middle low if we want, with now in the recent years many immigrants coming from the Middle East, Syria, from Iraq, from Pakistan, many, then from the Far East like Sri Lanka, then the Philippines, and then also lately some from South America, and mostly from what we call Central America, you know, Nicaragua, Salvador, and all that. We are a multi-ethnic community, a parish, multicultural. According to our bishop, this is the most mixed parish from a cultural point of view. We have some 7 masses over the weekend, as I said before, in those 4 languages, and we have many groups, over 20 groups of all kinds and sorts. The great challenge in here is to bring unity among all these different groups, and of course the different masses that they attend, to bring unity and communion in this society that is typically multicultural, very open, where there is a great acceptance. People are very straightforward. Nobody is called Mr. or Mrs. Everybody is called by the first name, whoever he is. It's a society very informal, if we want, but very, how can I say, competitive at the same time, because we are in North America and it's the land of opportunities, so those who work, they will get there. Then we also have a great challenge in here, which is to welcome or to facilitate the coming of new immigrants, refugees. We in the parish are particularly busy with that. We've got a specific committee that deals with that, where we sometimes support the people financially, those who come, for 1 year, which is not little. Others is a so-called moral sponsorship. We do all the paperwork and put everything together so that the department or the Ministry of Immigration allows them to be settled. Then we've got to guarantee their financial upkeeping during the first year while they start working and all that. Canada doesn't want to receive people without qualifications, without the possibility of work, and that's why the entities that sponsor migrants or refugees, they have to have the financial tools to give a dignified life to these people, dignified homes and all that, so that they don't end up in the streets as it happens in other parts of the world. Another challenge that we might have is how to welcome, especially now lately, the people that come from the Middle East, where, you know, none of us has got familiarity with the language, for example. It's a people very devout, for sure, very religious, but we find this barrier in between, which is the language which we don't, we are not prepared, you know, not for this time. Looking ahead, this parish will be more and more mixed culturally and you know, even by country of origin, because the area was inhabited mainly by descendants of Italians and perhaps some Irish and so-called English-speaking people, but those are becoming old every day and they are dying, and the new people coming in is from other parts of the world, as I said before, very, very mixed. Honestly, it's also an area with great challenges from a social point of view. There's quite a bit of, you know, criminality in some areas of this parish, for lack of work or for lack of possibilities, especially for the youth. And so very often dramatic events take place, like shootings and all that kind of stuff. And I believe this is what we have to say at this moment for the parish of St. Andrews in Etobicoke, Toronto, Canada.